Cockerbelly.
Hey guys, Newt here. So before we brought you our Velvet Rope trailers, which we shot for Arcana Comics, and you guys were like, hey, dickheads, what else you got? Which is, the internet is so fucking mean. Did you know that?
Yeah.
So what we have also is something that we shot that Justin Silverman and I worked on. It actually started years ago as an Underbelly comic book called Nerds, Girls, Guns, and Ghouls. And then we altered it because we found out the Angry Video Game Nerd movie was going to be about the Nintendo cartridges buried in New Mexico. That's what our script was about as well. So we adapted into the Polybius myth about an arcade machine. And then Justin and I got together with our friend Steve Carino here.
How you doing?
And we all met at a South Jersey Wendy's, like big shot Hollywood executives do. And we started to put together Geeks, Girls, Guns, and Ghouls, which is a promo for a feature that we would like to make in the future. Maybe you guys can help us with that. Steve, give us a little background on how you got involved with this.
You call me up and basically says, Steve, do this for me.
That's pretty much how things
That's basically
work.
How it works, yeah.
I had this goofy idea about a haunted video game and sexy girls and guns and monsters. And within a couple weeks, we were working with our friend Todd Tuckey, who owns TNT Amusements. We shot our six-player X-Men Let's Play with them. And you guys had put together an actual physical Polybius machine.
Yeah, actually, when we talked to Todd and we tried to pitch the idea so we can work over at TNT Amusements, he was like, well, what's this machine all about? And so we showed him on Google Images, like, you know, basically this machine is an urban legend myth. People out there are actually building their own Polybius machines. Mm-hmm. So we showed Todd all the different Polybius machines that are out there. And Todd's like, when was this machine supposed to be made? And we were like, well, it was like
1981,
whatever. And he's looking at it and goes, well, that can't be it because that's a 1987 Williams cabinet. And that can't be it because that's a 1986 Sega cabinet. So he's like, you need a machine that nobody knows. So he takes us in this warehouse, and this warehouse is like the end of Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. It's like the warehouse from Raiders of the Lost Ark is this never-ending aisles of vintage video game stock,
two, three high. Yeah. Okay.
And he's like, there, behind all these different machines, there's just a cabinet with a monitor, and it was a bootleg machine that's not any major manufacturer machine. And I had to go back and create graphics. I had to figure out what is the gameplay based on all the information I could find on it. So I took a variation of Tempest, and I didn't know exactly what is supposed to happen when you play it.
Yeah.
So I figured if you play it long enough, you will unlock satanic symbols.
Yeah, and it kind of opens up, kind of like the puzzle box in Hellraiser was kind of the idea that we had. We puppeteered practical effects in a fish tank because we wanted it to be like Poltergeist. So we literally went to your office and we were puppeteering a plastic skull in a fish tank and shooting that for the end shot.
Yeah. And it gave it a whole other quality because, I mean, like, you'll see a lot of like CGI effects or whatever, video co-pilot stuff, if you guys are in editing and you know what that is. But the skull stuff, we wanted to make a little bit more special. And I really like old school Industrial Light and Magic stuff. I love the visual.
Even my hand coming out, my hand coming out of the thing, we wanted it to be like the scene in Prince of Darkness.
Yeah.
You know, so that was kind of our idea, the John Carpenter movie. So, I mean, this was a lot of fun to put together. It's one of those things, again, where it's like, I have this dumb idea and all of a sudden I get everybody excited about it. And next thing you know, there's an actual Polybius machine and there's us doing this and that. And what we came up with is this, and take a look at it.
History of video games. One arcade machine has become legend. Some say it's a myth. Others deny its existence. Secret in purpose. Evil in design. Lost in time. Until now.
I think Polybius is a myth.
And I say it's real.
I knew I had to call you guys when I saw it come off the truck from Portland.
Ooh, we're gonna have to plug this sucker in.
Is it over? Did we win? So that was the promo trailer that we did for Geeks Girls Guns and Ghouls, no longer Nerds Girls Guns and Ghouls. The head of Arcana said, it sounds better if it's all G's. And I said, you've made more money than I have. I run a movie theater. Steve did an amazing job putting that together, making my dumb idea come to life. Justin Silverman obviously was a huge help in it, like he always is. We hope to one day make this into a feature film. So comment on there if you dug it. Let us know what you thought of it. Hit up Arcana because they're trying to help us put this one together as well. And thank you for coming out, Steve, tonight and helping us out. Thank you for making another amazing piece of art for me based on my dumb ideas. Yeah. And look out for more Underbelly, guys. Now that we're getting through all the stuff that we've shot in the past, we're going to get into new content. Leave us a comment below because as we are going to be getting into new content, let us know what you'd like to see us cover.
Awesome.
Now I can go home. It's been a long night.